Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I want to show you how to compare two sets of data side by side in a double bar histogram. What we did in the first video is we took the two serial ratings, company G and company K, and we found measures of center and measures of variation for those and sort of compared those. In the second video, we took all the data together and we made class limits with five classes, including the very minimum value and the very maximum value for the two sets. And then we created a frequency distribution table and a histogram using the data analysis feature. Now in this one, I want to separate the class, frequencies for the K and the G serials. So I still want to use the same class limits for both because I want to compare those. And to compare those, I want to see them side by side in the same classes. So we have the frequency for G and the frequency for K. The class limits are going to be the same. So I'm going to go ahead and control C. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, control V. You could just click on one and it would go down there too. In order to get rid of that, you're going to hit escape. Now I want to find the frequency for G. And when I do that, I want to highlight one more cell than I actually have for classes. And because then it's going to tell me the last cell should be zero, saying none of your values are outside your class limits, which is good. So notice this is gray, but I have a white bar at the top. I'm going to click here and equal frequency. And then parentheses, my data array that I'm going to use is here. And to capture that, I'm going to click on the top value and click on Control Shift Down. Down arrow is what I mean by down. And that's going to put that in there. You could just type it right in, or you can also just drag down and select it. And then a comma. And now the bins array. And the bins are these values up here, the upper limit, because this is how Excel is going to find the frequency by looking at the top value from each class. So this is what I'm using there. Now I'm going to click right up here and click on parentheses, and then I'm going to hit Control Shift Enter. This will not work if you just hit Enter, so make sure you're hitting Control Shift Enter, and that takes those frequencies right down the row. I'm going to do the same thing for K. I'm going to hit Equal Frequency. I want to make sure that I pick up the right data. So for the data array, I'm going to go on the B column, Control Shift Down, and that's going to put that right in there, then a comma. Again, my bins are the upper limits, so I have that, and then I'm going to click in here, put the parentheses, and then hit Control Shift Enter. And there's my frequencies, and I can make that look a little nice. Let's make my little table here have lines around it. So that it stands out. And now I'm going to take this and I'm going to make a histogram with double bars. So I'm going to highlight this whole thing. I'm not highlighting the zeros down here. Those just told me there were no values outside of my classes, which is fine. Now with that highlighted, I'm going to go to Insert and I'm going to click on this double bar graph. Now, I don't want it to be right here. You can see it's kind of nice. I'm not quite done yet though. So I have it here. I'm going to put it beside my what I have here. It's got a legend down here, which is nice. It's got my class limits down here. But remember, a histogram should not have spaces between the bars. So click on that and then go up to, well, we're on design. You want to make sure that you're in design to be able to see this. And then quick layout. And then number 8 has the look that we're interested in. I can also change the axis of my graph, the titles of my axis, by clicking in there. Let's say this is my class limits. And this is frequency. And I also want to call this comparing G and K. As my title. And then maybe if I click on this, I decide I want to also get that legend back in there. So I have a legend in there and I could add other things too. But I think this is enough for me. So there's my chart. And then maybe what I'm going to be asking, or somebody might be asking you looking at this graph, what do you see when you compare these two? This is a rating and we are assuming the higher the rating, the better. And so when I look at this, I can say that K definitely seemed to have a better rating. It had the high rating over here and way higher than everybody else. And then it also had was higher than the blue in each of these far cases. And the only time it was lower than blue was when we were looking at the low ratings. So based on this graph alone, I would say that K is being rated higher than G. All right, have a fantastic day. In the next video, I'll show you how to do a frequency polygon.